beautiful Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Welcome to Premier Boxing Champions from Bell Center, home of the Montreal Canadiens. In our main event, 35-year-old Lucien Boutte, who has lived here in Montreal for the last 12 years, back in the ring following a 19-month layoff. He will take on 33-year-old Andrea De Luisa, a top European contender fighting in North America for the first time. Montreal, we come to you from north of the border for Premier Boxing Champions from the Bell Center. In our first bout, two unbeatens. Alaider Alvarez, a 2008 Olympian who lives here in Montreal. Alvarez will take on Isidro Prieto, getting set for his first fight outside South America. Followed by our main event. On the left, Andrea De Luisa up against Montreal native Lucien Boutte. And we welcome you inside Bell Center for what should be a terrific evening of boxing action as Premier Boxing Champions. I'm Kenny Albert. I'll be joined by Sugar Ray Leonard, BJ Flores, and Kenny Rice. Let's take a look at tonight's card. First, a 12-round bout between two unbeatens born in South America, 31-year-old Alaider Alvarez, record of 17-0. He will take on 29-year-old Isidro Prieto, comes in at 24-0 with three draws. And then our main event, 35-year-old Lucien Boutte at 31-2, record of 19-1 here at Bell Center, up against Andrea De Luisa, 17-2 with 13 knockouts. And I'm joined now by Sugar Ray Leonard and BJ Flores. Ray, you are back in Montreal, the site of your Olympic gold medal triumph back in 1976. Can you believe it's been 39 summers? And then 4 years later, your first fight against Roberto Duran. So when you got off the plane the other day, did it stir up some memories?
Without question, Kenny. Fond memories. I've come back here because this is where it all began. Won the gold medal, took the gold medal to Palmer Park, Maryland, my home. And all of a sudden, my career started. Fight with Roberto Duran wasn't good, but it taught me how to be a better fighter, smarter fighter.
Well, you got him the next time, and they love you here in Montreal, and they also love Lucien Boutte. He's lived here for 12 years. He was born in Romania, and he has become a fan favorite.
Oh, they love him. In fact, this is the perfect setting for Boutte. I mean, he's coming here. He's trying to reestablish himself after a 19-month layoff, which is a big factor. He wants to show the world that he's back.
And Boutte will take on Andrea De Luisa, BJ Flores, who will be fighting outside Italy for the first time in his professional career.
Yeah, Kenny, De Luisa has a very big task in front of him tonight. Coming into the Bell Center facing former world champion Lucien Boutte, it's not going to be easy. But if he wants to win, he's got to do exactly what he told us yesterday in the fighter meetings. He's got to be aggressive. He's got to stay away from the left hand of Lucien Boutte, get on the inside, and make it rough on the former champion.
So it will be Boutte and De Luisa in our main event, but first up, Prieto and Alvarez. And Ray, when you talk about Prieto, he's fighting outside South America for the first time.
Well, Prieto's a relatively unknown fighter, but he's extremely confident. He's poised. I mean, look at him now. I mean, he's really in control. And he told me yesterday that he's here to win. He's not here to take pictures or to be on vacation. He's here to win.
And his opponent is Alaider Alvarez, BJ. And Alvarez, like Boutte, lives here in Montreal. In fact, he'll be fighting at Bell Center for the 14th time.
Yeah, Kenny, he's got a lot of experience fighting here at the Bell Center, and he's definitely got the home field advantage. He told us yesterday, listen, my left arm feels fantastic now. My left jab is my best punch. I'm going to use it tonight. I'm going to look for that early in the fight from Alaider Alvarez to take control of a very aggressive and strong Prieto, put him on his back heels, and look to land his combinations.
Alvarez is trained by Mark Ramsey, who spoke earlier with our Kenny Rice.
Later, Alvarez was undefeated coming into this fight. And about 5 years ago as an amateur, this man, Mark Ramsey, discovered him, brought him into your deep stable that you have here. Mark, in the time you've had him, what's been the progression to get to this point where he's moving into real contention?
But he was already a very good amateur boxer, technically very good boxer, probably the best jab on the light heavyweight division. And now he picked up a little bit in his progression as a professional, with a professional style, became a very good boxer, puncher. And I think, like, right now we are one of the best of the division, no doubt.
You said that he may have the best jab in the division. Is it going to take that tonight? How does he win this fight?
But he need to impose that jab. He's boxing around, like, good distance, very good counter-punching also. Like, we have a tough opponent, somebody who's very physically very strong, but we need to use all your tools or her tools to win that fight, no doubt.
He certainly looks good back there.
Thank you.
All right, good luck to you.
Thank you.
Behind Kenny Rice and Mark Ramsey, a look at Oleyder Alvarez comes in with a record of 17-0. He gets it to take on fellow unbeaten Isidro Prieto. It's coming up next on Premier Boxing Champions from Bell Center in Montreal. Premier Boxing Champions on NBCSN is brought to you by Corona, who invites you to find your beach. By 1800 Tequila, enough said. And by Applebee's half-price apps every weekday, late afternoon and late night. The scene outside Bell Center in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. As we get set for Alvarez and Prieto. Let's take a look at the Corona tail of the tape. Alvarez, 17-0. Prieto, 24-0 with three draws, scheduled for 12 in the light heavyweight division. Alvarez, 2 years older than Prieto, has the 2.5-inch reach advantage. Both fighters weighing just over 174 pounds. Look at the rules. No standing eight count, no three knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. The fighter cannot be saved by the bell on any round. The fight will become official after four rounds. To arena announcer, Roland Bayard.
Une présentation, ce combat est une présentation de Vidéotron en collaboration avec Mise au jeu. Ce combat de championnat de la catégorie mi-lourd est prévu en 12 rounds. This championship fight in the light heavyweight division is scheduled for 12 rounds. Les juges, the judges, Barry Lindenman, Alejandro Rothschild, Jack Whitberg, l'arbitre, the referee, Michael Griffin. Dans le coin rouge, in the red corner, détenteur d'un dossier de 24 victoires, 20 par KO et 3 verdicts nuls. With a record of 24 wins, 20 by knockouts, and 3 draws. From Buenos Aires, Argentina, Isidro El Guerrero Ranoni Prieto. Dans le coin bleu, in the blue corner, invaincu après 17 combats, 10 victoires par KO. In the blue corner, undefeated after 7 fights with 10 wins by KO. De Montréal au Québec, Elider Storm Alvarez.
Mark. You men both receive my instructions, all right? I want you to obey my commands. I want you to protect yourselves at all times, okay? Good luck to both of you. Touch gloves now, man. You're boxing the bell.
Referee Michael Griffin. A look at 31-year-old Oleyder Alvarez, born in Colombia, lives here in Montreal. It's his 13th fight here at Bell Center as he gets set to take on Isidro Prieto. His last 8 fights have taken place in Argentina, where he now lives. He was born in Paraguay. Round one scheduled for 12 in the light heavyweight division. Two unbeatens, both born in South America. Oh, big right by Alvarez.
Kenny Alvarez told us yesterday he's going to come out and establish the jab earlier. So far, I've seen him go to that overhand right two times in that corner. Good connects by Alvarez.
Well, right away, Alvarez didn't really feel his man out. He just went straight for him. Very aggressive. Smart thing. Catch a man early. Things do happen.
Alvarez is healthy. Recently underwent surgery to remove bone fragments from his elbow. This is his second fight since the surgery. And he feels a lot stronger. He was an Olympian back in 2008 in Beijing. Lost his first bout to the eventual bronze medalist, Tony Jeffries, out of Great Britain.
Yeah, Kenny had a nice amateur background. The kid definitely knows how to fight. He's got very good fundamentals, but, you know, he told us yesterday at the fighter meetings, I'm going to use that left jab, but we got to remember he is South American and the kid can't bang. So he showed us that early.
What have you noticed early, Ray?
Well, Prieto, he's really dropping that left hand. Keep an eye on that left hand because that's a counter for a right hand.
See Prieto trying to set up that nice overhand right up top. He's not the quickest guy in the world, Ray, but he's got good timing and he's got decent head movement. So Alvarez definitely is going to have a couple things to deal with early in this fight.
Neither fighter has lost as a professional as we approach 1 minute remaining in round one.
I'd like to see Alvarez work up that jab up and down to the body, to the head.
Oh, big right hook from Prieto.
Trying to confuse his man.
And then we saw the left jab from Alvarez.
And definitely something we talked about yesterday, Kenny. If Alvarez is going to try to establish his jab, what does Prieto got to do? He's got to take away that jab with the overhand right, slip inside, land the uppercuts, the hooks off of that. So good strategy by Prieto here in this first round. Take away that Alvarez jab.
Seconds remaining in round one from Montreal. There's that left jab from Alvarez once again. Down to 15 seconds. Big right hook by Alvarez. And then Prieto comes back with a right. And that will do it for round one. Well, here in Montreal, we take you back to 1976, Olympic Stadium, one of the venues when this city hosted the Summer Olympic Games. You can still see the Olympic rings lit downtown. There he is, 39 years ago. Our own Sugar Ray Leonard, who won gold, one of the early highlights of what became a Hall of Fame career. Ray, you never lost a round. You won all 30 rounds in Montreal back in 76.
It was my most cherished moments. I mean, one of them, but it was so special. Yesterday, I went to the arena.
Maurice Richard Arena at Olympic Park. Your first five bouts took place there, and then you won the gold medal at the iconic Montreal Forum. What do you remember about that day?
Oh, special, determined. I mean, it was such a blessing to compete against the best.
How did it feel to step back into Maurice Richard Arena yesterday?
Oh, it was, I shook like a baby. So special.
Where can we get one of those Muhammad Ali sweatshirts?
I'll talk to you later.
Tremendous. 39 years ago.
Wow.
Speaking of shaking, Prieto caught Alvarez with a very strong right hand at the end of that first round. Definitely got the attention of Alvarez. Great shot by Prieto. Good timing.
Alvarez was hurt too for a moment.
You had a look at Corey Erdman's scorecard. He did award round one to a later Alvarez. Alvarez at 17-0 with 10 knockouts. He won gold at the Pan Am Games in Rio back in 2007.
And if you're in the corner of Alvarez, you don't want to start letting Prieto get the timing on that jab. You're going to tell Alvarez, hey, taunt, feint, mix it up, go up and down, change speeds on that punch. Don't let him set you up and time you with that overhand right because he's got a heavy punch, right?
Prieto has very heavy hands. And you know, you call the term heavy hands. She said, what does that mean? That means that it's like George Foreman. George Foreman has heavy hands.
Now, BJ, we also continue to see the head movement that you talked about in the first round from Prieto.
Yeah, and it's nothing special, Kenny. It's not like he's out there a super flashy guy, but he's got good timing. You see him move side to side. His head is on a swivel. It's off the center. As long as it's off the center, he's not in danger. So, you know, ripping those right hands and those body shots, those unconventional uppercuts, this fight's going to be interesting.
Round two scheduled for 12 in the light heavyweight division. Prieto, born in Paraguay, moved to Argentina at the age of 19. He worked 16-hour days in construction as a bricklayer and a painter. Taught himself to box, really did not have any formal training.
That's amazing, man, from where he is now. But I also noticed that when he throws, and Prieto, he kind of probes his jab. He doesn't really take advantage of it, extend it, and use it hard to really, you know, to really throw your opponents off balance. He just wants to drop that right hand, which is a power punch.
And you know, Ray, I agree with you. You know, certain fighters can get away with that, certain fighters can't, but so far, Prieto has found a way to land that right hand even without the use of the left jab.
And the thing about it, his punches, when they land, they hurt.
He's definitely heavy-handed.
He's the outsider fighting outside South America for the first time in his career. His 28th professional fight. Alvarez fighting for the 18th time. 16 of the 18 bouts here in Montreal.
And you see early in this fight, Kenny, who's got the heavier hands and who's got the speed. Alvarez has got to stick to his game plan and make sure he doesn't make any mistakes tonight.
Round two, winding down. Scheduled for 12 from Bell Center in Montreal. Later, Alvarez fighting at home.
We take a look here at round one. The beautiful overhand right that Prieto landed definitely stunned Elidier Alvarez. Caught him with a nice shot here in the last round. Good combinations by both guys. More even round, more of an Alvarez round. But he definitely got the attention of Alvarez in that first round, Ray. Caught him with a nice overhand right on the temple. Those hurt.
Yeah, he stunned him for a while.
And you saw the legs of Alvarez kind of stiffen up there for a second. You got to remember, in the first round, both fighters, you know, neither one of them are that loose yet. They haven't broken a sweat. And a lot of times you can catch a guy cold in that first round.
And that's what happened there, pretty much. Alvarez, I think, is respect, too. He's keeping those hands a little higher.
Round three scheduled for 12 from Bell Center in Montreal. Two unbeaten fighters, the later Alvarez and Isidro Prieto.
And I really like to see Alvarez with that back heel up, you know, kind of a lot of the weight on the back leg. It shows he's ready to spring, he's ready to come forward, slide back out. He knows he's got to establish his distance and his range whenever he's in with Prieto. He's got to get in and then out. Nice right hand by Prieto, good timing. But he's got to put combinations together more.
A look at Corey Erdman's scorecard. He awarded round two to Alvarez. So Alvarez winning the first two rounds, according to Corey. You agree, guys?
It's pretty close. I mean, and Prieto told me yesterday, he said, I will win this fight, period.
Kenny, I gave Alvarez a second round for sure, but based on that big right hand, you know, in the first round, Prieto could have stolen that round. You know, he definitely wobbled Alvarez and gave him, you know, landed the harder shot in that round, and it was a hard shot.
Ray alluding to Prieto's comment yesterday, he said, I am 100% confident I will win. I am not here on vacation.
On vacation. That was pretty cute. But he meant that. 100% he meant that.
And he also said he feels he needs to make a statement to the judges and win by stoppage or by a convincing decision up against the hometown, the later Alvarez.
Nice overhand right by Prieto again a second ago. He's definitely getting the timing of Alvarez like we talked about in the last round. Alvarez has got to mix the speed up of that jab to make sure Prieto can't time it. But Prieto's still not doing enough to win the rounds, but you can tell he's getting close.
It seems to be a little
cut
over the right eye.
Yeah, blood dripping down the right cheek of Prieto with 1 minute remaining in round three. As Michael Griffin separates the fighters.
I would assume it was from a punch. I haven't seen many clash of heads, you know, so far in the first three rounds, guys.
Nice combination by Prieto has Alvarez up against the ropes.
And this is where Prieto wants to be. We talked about the speed advantage of Alvarez. And Prieto can take away that speed by coming on the inside, being close to Alvarez and making him pay with looping shots.
30 seconds remaining in round three. Big right by Prieto.
Big overhand right there. And he set it up with a jab down and came back up. Beautiful shot. And he hurt Alvarez with that shot, Ray.
And to think this guy never had any form of training in boxing.
And he had a very limited amateur career.
Alvarez has got to be careful not to make mistakes, guys. He can't get in the wheelhouse of Prieto.
Final seconds of round three. Terrific round for Prieto.
Can you see the story of this fight so far?
Back in Montreal, Isidro Prieto coming off his best round here, the third round that was just finished. First time he has fought outside of his native South America, but that doesn't intimidate him. He was telling us at the fighter meeting yesterday, he was a poor kid growing up in Paraguay. He had to find any odd job he can just to make a living for his family. That included everything from being a painter to a construction worker. I said, what's your toughest job? He said, really the first one. I didn't know what I was doing, but I adapted quickly by watching everyone, much like he's doing in this fight, Kenny Albert.
And he was terrific in round three. After Corey gave Alvarez the first two rounds on his scorecard.
Hey! No punches. Step back.
You see the big free swing in Prieto there. You know, he's really loading up on those shots, Kenny. That's his style. He likes to fight that way. If he would invest in the body a little bit, he won't miss as much, right?
Well, this is happening with Prieto because, he hasn't had formal training. And these are just signs of the inexperience or the basic fundamentals.
Corey, how did you score round three?
Guys, I gave that round to Prieto. I have it scored 2-1 for Alvarez right now. The first round could have gone either way. The one thing I'm noticing is that Prieto's overhand rights are making Alvarez doubt whether or not he wants to throw that jab.
All right, thanks very much, Corey. So Alvarez with the one-point edge over the first three rounds on Corey's scorecard. Again, Alvarez up against the ropes, comes back with the right uppercut.
And even if Alvarez is getting off better on the inside, this is where Prieto has to be to win this fight. So he knows he's going to go through some rocky moments to get in with Alvarez. But overall, he's going to have the advantage on the inside. That's where he wants his fight to take place, right?
But I love what I see in Prieto throwing body shots, throwing head shots, up and down, looping right hands, a variation of punches.
And you know, Alvarez is still doing the majority of the landing, but you gotta like what you see from the kid who's coming out of South America for the very first time and didn't get the memo that he's the opponent tonight.
You know, BJ, he's holding his own.
Up against Alvarez, who was born in Colombia, lives right here in Montreal. This is his home arena, fighting at Bell Center for the 14th time in 18 professional bouts. Oh, big right by Alvarez.
And see, Alvarez lands a big right hand. Prieto comes back with another one. It seems like he takes the shots better, Ray, on the inside.
He does, but Alvarez needs to become the boxer. He needs to use the ring.
He told us he was going to use that left jab yesterday. So far, he's kind of getting suckered into a bit of a dogfight with Prieto, and that's exactly what he doesn't want to do.
You see that 1-2 by Alvarez, that left jab and that right hand? Uppercut, beautiful shot.
Beautiful right uppercut that Prieto just walked him right into. And he lost his footing.
Yep, rolled his slip. 15 seconds remaining in round four. Scheduled for 12. Later Alvarez. Isidro Prieto.
And you see the action that took place in the last round. Prieto really digging to the body there, doing some good inside work. This is where Prieto wants the fight to take place. Alvarez counters with a nice right uppercut, good position. You see Prieto walking him into a nice lead right uppercut. Very unconventional, Ray. Loses his footing there. Referee rules it a slip. Another look at the uppercut. Nice accuracy right on the chin of Alvarez. Got distracted, just saw a picture of Adonis Stevenson in the crowd. The crowd made a little noise.
Terrific crowd on hand here at Bell Center. As we begin round five. Alvarez called this bout the biggest challenge of my career, but he also said he will face a new Alvarez following the elbow surgery.
Yeah, he talked about that and how important the use of his left jab was tonight, Kenny. I think he came out from the gates, wanted to establish that punch, and the right hand of Prieto's kind of made Alvarez put that back in the tool bag for now.
His jab is not as consistent as it can be and should be.
Yeah, he's still using it, but he's allowing, Prieto to crowd him and kind of come in when he wants and not making him pay when he comes in.
But look at Prieto. He goes to the body. He works his way in. I like to see more jabs from Prieto also to get closer, which he's doing now.
Nice body shot by Alvarez on the inside, and then right back to that left stick.
Alvarez has taken three of the first four rounds on our Corey Erdman scorecard.
That looping right hand that Prieto has been throwing, that's kind of a surprise punch. That should come not every round, but every other round to try to catch your man off balance.
I mean, I think he can use it, Ray, but he's got to mix in other things with it. He can't just do it every time. So he's got to, vary up the attack a little bit, change it high-low.
Well, he's also reaching in, too. He's actually telegraphing it.
It never helps with a slick boxer like Alvarez. He just slides back with his feet and sticks that jab, and he's getting a little bearings, a little better better gauge on the spacing and the balance for this round. He's boxing a little better than this fifth round.
Two unbeaten fighters. Alvarez 17-0. Prieto 24-0 with three draws. Lucien Boutte will take on Andrea De Luisa.
You know, Prieto is not that experienced, so as this fight goes into the later rounds, I want to see. It'd be interesting to see how he handles the later rounds.
That's a great point, Ray. Prieto has fought past the sixth round in only two of his 27 pro bouts.
That can become a factor there.
Absolutely. Alvarez has got a lot more experience going deep into fights, but, you know, like we talked about earlier in the fight, nice right hand by Alvarez. Good punch.
He stunned Prieto.
I think Prieto's taking those shots well, Kenny, on the inside. He's kind of rolling with them, and it doesn't seem like they're affecting him too much, even though they're clean shots by Alvarez and very powerful shots as well.
You know, I would say he is taking those shots, but he just has a good chin.
Time winding down in round five. Alvarez and Prieto here in Montreal. September 26th in prime time on NBC, American heavyweight Deontay Wilder will put his perfect record on the line in his home state of Alabama. The card also features Omar Figueroa Jr. 2 weeks before that, former champion Peter Quillin faces off against Michael Zarafa. Deontay Wilder, Ray, at 34-0. 33 of his 34 wins have come via knockout.
You know what? Every fight, he gets better and better.
And I've always been impressed with Deontay Wilder and, you know, his fight with Berman Stavern. He showed a lot of tools that a lot of people hadn't seen from him yet. Nice left hook by Prieto. Caught Alvarez again in the corner.
And then he came back with a right. And another. And a right uppercut from Prieto. And then a left jab from Alvarez.
Nice, straight left jab by Prieto on the inside. This is where he needs the fight to take place for him to win. This is his only shot.
They both are just letting go of their punches, throwing bombs here.
Furious action here in the sixth round, a right by Alvarez.
Beautiful shot by Alvarez on that right ear, kind of a cupping right hand. After he makes that and connects on that shot, why not slide off to the right? Why come right back to the middle and give Prieto another chance to land?
And he has that experience.
Hands are free. Hands are free, guys.
Fighter separated by referee Michael Griffin.
And both men are in tremendous shape because it's been a pretty fast pace. They've been going at each other.
Oh, big right by Prieto.
Alvarez is in trouble, guys. He got hit with a big shot there. He's not all the way there right there. And Prieto told us in the fighter meetings, when he sees blood, he goes for the kill. That's exactly what's going on right now.
And Alvarez has never been knocked out as a pro.
Alvarez is still hurt right now. Very important. Prieto gets right back on him.
And talking about the blood, he told me yesterday, I see blood, I become more aggressive.
1 minute remaining in round six.
There's a lot of time left.
And that slip kind of seized and killed the momentum that Prieto had going on right there. You know, Alvarez is hurt. An extra 15, 20 seconds allows him to regain his head a little bit, right?
And now, with the experience, this is when you go to the body. You bring those hands down.
Very important when you get your man hurt that you focus on the body after that. Alvarez has been shook a couple times in this fight, three or four times from that overhand right. It's the one punch we talked about that he's got to watch out for. So far, it doesn't seem like he's made any adjustments to get out of the way of that shot.
And it's kind of a blinding shot because it comes over. It's a looping punch.
Oh, big left by Prieto. Out of right.
Those right hands by Prieto are really starting to find a home. And we're only at the halfway mark of the fight. The question I have is, can Alvarez continue to take those shots for six more rounds? He's winning the fight so far, but he might win the war, not the battle.
Round six, winding down.
Some good combinations here from Prieto. You see him setting up that overhand right, the punch we talked about, Ray. He drops down like he's going to the body and brings it up top. Alvarez did have his left hand up that time. Later in the round, you see it again. It caught him right on the chin. This time, Alvarez wasn't ready for the punch, and Prieto took advantage of a very shooken up Elidier Alvarez. A slip a little later in the round gave Alvarez some much-needed time to rest and recover.
Smart takedown by Alvarez, giving him some time. Tonight's quarter camp brought to you by 1800 Tequila, enough said.
Somehow, some way, Alvarez weathered the storm, and there were some big punches thrown by Prieto. You can't take too many more of those because it's wear and tear.
Yeah, he's taking a lot of punches. You know, not so many that he's taken a number of punches, but the quality of punches that he's taken, Ray, they've definitely taken his toll. And you know, Alvarez has a good chin, but Prieto is very heavy-handed, like you mentioned earlier in the broadcast.
So for Prieto, guys, this is only the third time in 28 pro bouts he has gone into the seventh round. Let's check in with Kenny Rice. Kenny.
Thanks, Kenny. With Mark Ramsey over here in the Alvarez corner. Mark, what did you tell your man before this round?
First of all, we want him to move a little bit more on his right because, like you can see, the only punch the other guys use is the over and the right. And we want Elidier Alvarez to go away from that punch. But also, he's working in better when in short distance. And this is what we want from him now.
Not many people have taken your guy this long into a fight. Do you think that might have frustrated him some?
Yes, a little bit. But now it's time to recuperate the situation around good technique and good jab. And it's going to be okay.
Thanks, Mark. Kenny.
All right, Mark Ramsey, the trainer for Elidier Alvarez. Midway through round seven, scheduled for 12.
Kenny, I agree with Mark. He's got to move away from the right hand of Prieto. Just walk over to your right side. You don't have to sit right in front of Prieto and let him load up with that shot. Shoot your combination, get it off, and step over to the right. Eliminate danger. Back to that stick, up and down. Stick it to the body, stick it to the head. And then use those taunts and those feints to make sure he doesn't get his timing.
You see, when Prieto throws those overhand rights, Alvarez should be using that jab and keep him off balance. Once he throws that shot, he's off balance.
He is, and you saw him a little earlier, you know, a round and a half ago, he countered with that right uppercut. That's something that I would look for him to do down the stretch and maybe take away the right hand of Prieto.
You're so right, BJ. In fact, Alvarez needs to stay a little closer. But give him angles.
Oh, big right by Prieto.
Because he's right in front of him. That's why those punches are landing.
And those overhead rights are very difficult to get out of the way of, so Alvarez has been catching him, but there's also nothing wrong with dropping underneath one of those shots, because when Prieto misses one of those, he's going to be off balance. That's going to give Alvarez a chance to counter.
And Prieto right now fighting with his hands down.
Yeah, he hasn't done enough in this round, in my opinion, but He's loading up too much and not setting anything up.
The final 10 seconds of round 7 here in Montreal. There he is, BJ. You mentioned Adonis Stevenson here at Bell Center tonight.
175-pound WBC champion Adonis Stevenson. Everybody definitely looking for that fight between him and Sergey Kovalev. We'll see when it happens, Kenny.
Stevenson at 26-1, watching the two unbeatens, Elena Alvarez and Isidro Prieto. Corey Erdman's scorecard, Alvarez with the three-point edge over the first 8 rounds.
Prieto is getting a little confident. Should bring those hands up a little higher. You just have to be cautious.
Round 8 scheduled for 12 from Bell Center in Montreal, Quebec.
And you see Prieto's kind of stopped coming forward quite as aggressively as he was a few rounds ago. So if I'm Alvarez, I'm going to really seize the initiative here and really try to push him even further back on his heels by working that jab and working some body shots as well.
He's buying time here. Prieto's buying time. Getting a break here, which is smart.
And now the crowd attempting to spur Alvarez on, fighting in his hometown.
And this is where Alvarez can really use that experience, Kenny. This is the latter stages of the fight, and he can really take advantage of a guy who hasn't been past 6 rounds only a couple times.
That little break that Prieto took, you'll see him come back.
I see Prieto getting more sloppy here, Kenny. And, you know, he's trying to load up, and he's allowing Alvarez to really outbox him and control him with the jab and the combinations.
And how key was that moment earlier when both fighters got tangled up and slipped? That really helped Alvarez.
Yeah, veteran move by Alvarez. He took advantage of the opportunity. He fell down, brought Prieto down with him, and said, listen, if I'm going down, you're coming down with me, and it's going to take some time for us both to get our mouthpieces back in and get us back together. So I'm going to get an extra 20 seconds rest.
Have you ever tried that?
I've definitely been hurt in a fight before and tried to grab the guy, and I wasn't able to take him down. I got to work on my tackling skills, but looks like Alvarez got it pretty good.
Well, Alvarez also has great sparring partners here in Montreal, and that's part of the experience edge that he has over Prieto.
Yeah, he's in the same gym with Better Biev and also Jean Pascal, two great light heavyweight fighters, guys who are, you know, very high up in the rankings. So his daily workouts in the gym get him prepared for moments like this, right? Another good round for Alvarez here.
Right. Alvarez back in control as time winds down in round 8 from Bell Center in Montreal. Lucien Boutte getting set for our main event, his first fight in 19 months since his loss to the aforementioned Jean Pascal back in January of 2014. One of only 2 career defeats.
Yeah, some good work from Alvarez here in the last round. You see him coming up the middle with some combinations. He reestablished that jab in the last round. Nice right uppercut. Right when I say that by Prieto, but Alvarez had a good round and took it on my scorecard.
You see that hair, Ray? Alvarez said he gets a haircut every 8 days. He said, I need to look good for interviews and press conferences. Was that your philosophy as well?
I used to do 7 days.
7 days. I wonder how he picked 8. Alvarez with the edge here tonight on Corey's scorecard over the first 8 rounds. 78-74.
Nice counter left hook from Alvarez a second ago. He waited till Prieto shot that right hand. It was a little lazy. He brought it back a little slow. Countered it with a nice sharp left hook.
Round 9 scheduled for 12 to Kenny Rice.
All right, thanks, Kenny. The Prieto corner telling me between rounds here that they're telling their man, basically, go back out there and do what you were doing the last couple of rounds. The key is we wanted to get this late into the fight. We think that we can outlast Alvarez if we get this far. So we'll see if that strategy holds up over these next few rounds, Kenny.
And Prieto has never gone past 10 rounds. He's gone 10 rounds twice, only his third time past the sixth.
Well, if you notice, there's also not the snap on those punches from Prieto. They're becoming a little less powerful.
You know, I agree with the corner of Prieto, but only if he continued to put that same pressure on like he was in the early rounds. Right now, Alvarez can fight at this pace all day, and really, he's in control of the action now, guys.
Alvarez has gone the distance in seven of his 17 pro bouts.
Nice counter right uppercut by Alvarez. And he's just seeing the punches of Prieto a lot better. You know, sometimes it takes an experienced fighter a couple rounds to figure out where his opponent's punches are coming from, especially when they're awkward guys with no amateur experience. It makes it tougher sometimes.
Right, but with Prieto, he has so much confidence. I mean, he beams with confidence, no matter how less experienced he is.
Final minute, round nine.
Ray, I think he's got to get back to his game plan of being awkward and lunging in whenever Alvarez punches, because I think he's just giving Alvarez too much space to operate here, and Alvarez is running away with it.
I think he's also more exposed to being hit by a combination by Alvarez.
Yeah, when he sits on the outside like he's not attacking.
I mean, that left hook is just barely grazing. It's almost on target, thrown by Alvarez.
We talked about it before. Prieto's not used to going past six rounds, and we've seen it ever since round seven. You know, in the last round, Alvarez is kind of, you know, taking control of this fight a bit.
Make him work.
The final 10 seconds of round nine. Good job by Alvarez ducking out of the way with a couple of right hooks.
Take a look at some of the work in the last round. You see Alvarez sliding back, Prieto following him all the way back to the ropes, landing a good combination, but that nice counter right uppercut by Alvarez. Another good overhand right by Prieto, but Alvarez is starting to take that punch a lot better now, Ray, and he's starting to see the punch coming, so not as dangerous.
Our corner camera brought to you by 1800 Tequila. Enough said. Round 10, scheduled for 12 in Montreal. Kenny Albert, Sugar Ray Leonard, BJ Flores, and Kenny Rice. Two undefeated fighters. Later, Alvarez at 17-0. Isidro Prieto, 24-0 with three draws. Third time Prieto has gone to the 10th round in his career. Neither fighter.
One thing I see Prieto do was to try to throw that uppercut from outside. That's really asking for trouble.
Corey Irvin, how did you score round nine?
Round nine I gave to Alvarez. I do think that Alvarez is really taking control of this fight. Some of those early rounds were swing rounds, but even though Alvarez was getting hit with big shots, you still have to look at the body of the work in between those highlight reel shots.
88-83, Alvarez on Corey's scorecard over the first nine rounds.
No punches.
These are the deep rounds here. A lot of fighters can't go. I mean, the eighth, ninth, tenth round, 11th, 12th round, those are the serious rounds.
And it would have been very important, Ray, for Prieto to invest some more work into the body in this fight. He wasn't able to do that, and he could have, seen the effects of that work if he would have done that. But only landed the overhand right, shook Alvarez a few times, but wasn't able to get him out of there. Now Alvarez back in control. And you can see the physical strength of Alvarez in there. He's not a huge puncher. He's a good, solid puncher, but he's also physically strong, and he's in tremendous condition. So, you know, this pace of fight, he's very comfortable with, because he's walking his man back, the snap off the Prieto punches, and he's in control now, Ray.
You're absolutely right. He's in tremendous shape.
Final minute, round 10. Alvarez fighting here at Bell Center for the 14th time in his 18th professional fight.
Break!
He has gone past 10 rounds only once in his career.
And Kenny, this is the time in the fight where it's really important to remember your fundamentals. Nice left uppercut by Alvarez there.
Well, the fact that Alvarez says he wants a title shot soon, so it's important that he continues to fight the way he is now and not allow Prieto to get a big shot in. He has to fight this way. Stay aggressive. Work the jab. Put the punches in bunches.
Beautiful overhand right by Alvarez on the inside.
Round 10 winding down in Montreal.
Break! Break! Goodbye. Bye.
The rest of this fight brought to you with no commercial interruptions by Corona, who invites you to find your beach. Heading to the 11th round. First of two fights coming to you on Premier Boxing Champions. A look inside the locker room of Lucien Foute. Record of 31-2. It'll be his 28th fight here in his adopted city of Montreal as he gets set to take on Andrea De La Huesa. 17-2, all 19 of his previous fights have taken place in Italy.
A good combination by Alvarez in the last round. You see him shoot that 1-2 and then clean it up with a third punch, that nice, clean left uppercut. You're always taught to shoot combinations in twos and threes, Ray. Nice combination from Alvarez.
So now, Prieto heads to the 11th round, Ray, for the first time in his professional career.
And you can see the, I mean, he's a little slower, he's less aggressive, and a little more playful, but he's always on. He's still holding, I'm still impressed with what I see in him.
I'm impressed with his effort, Ray, but I think we've got to make sure and distinguish that, you know, even though we're impressed, he's not, you know, winning the fight. Alvarez is winning the fight, he's in control, but, you know, you got to love the heart of Prieto coming in, you know, from South America and really putting up forth a game effort.
Well, Alvarez is showing us experience.
From Prieto's standpoint, if you work 16-hour days in construction, what's fighting an 11th round?
And all the jobs he was telling us that he did. Good body shots by Alvarez right there in the clinch.
I was going to comment on that, BJ. Those shots are great. Deep. That was a good shot. To the midsection. It's really doing damage.
You see those shots were actually moving the feet of Prieto for the first time. You see, Prieto's always kind of had his feet planted in cement. He's able to really get leverage on those punches, but those body shots were moving him back physically.
Hands up free. Let him go. Don't push him. Don't push him.
And Alvarez just doesn't seem affected by the 11th round. Fatigue hasn't set in. He's still sharp. And if he would really focus and use his left jab now, Ray, he can really, really start to pick Prieto off and land some powerful combinations.
I think he's trying to really do some serious damage here. He stands so close.
He's trying to impose his will right now, but, you know, you still got to remember, Prieto's still dangerous. So use that jab when he gets inside, whip combinations off of it. And, you know, I think, like I said, Prieto slowed down just enough to where those combinations will get there.
But when Alvarez moves away, for some reason, he's getting hit by those looping right hands.
And when he moves straight back, yes, he's got to get his head side to side and pick an angle. Counter right uppercut off the right hand like we talked about. The eyes of Alvarez very alert and aware on the inside with Prieto.
You see the experience now with Alvarez. He's just trying to time his man. Let him reach and make him pay for it. Miss and make him pay for it.
Punches up. Punches up.
Down to a half minute remaining in the 11th round. Later, Alvarez, 17-0. Isidro Prieto at 24-0 with three draws. Alvarez with the edge on Corey Irvin's scorecard over the first 10 rounds tonight.
All right. Listen to Mike. Box.
That will do it for round 11. Yeah.
some really good work so far for both guys. A lot of the highlights going back and forth. Good uppercut inside from Alvarez. Nice overhand rights by Prieto throughout. Alvarez has started to regain control in the latter part of this fight. Nice shot there by Alvarez. More good work from Prieto. Just a lot of good two-way action here, Kenny. And I've been really impressed with Prieto early, and Alvarez down the stretch has shown why he is a world-class light heavyweight. More good stuff from Alvarez. Great combination punching. And in the last round, a nice body shot by Alvarez. Caught Prieto right on the belt area. Good shot. Prieto definitely felt the effects of that shot.
What's impressed you about Alvarez, Ray?
Well, the fact that he's poised. I mean, he was hurt a couple times, and he maintained his composure, and then he put his own punches together. That's a very experienced fighter.
We begin round 12.
It's a big round. Let everything go.
7-point edge for Alvarez on Corey Wolfman's scorecard.
Yeah, Kenny, the only way Prieto can win here is by scoring a knockout. He's got to hope for one of those overhand rights, catch Alvarez being a little lazy. But if you're on the opposite corner, if you're Alvarez, you really want to put an exclamation mark on a pretty good performance and really continue to press the action.
And if you look here, look at the bounce in Alvarez's legs. That means he's in tremendous shape.
Big overhand right by Prieto.
And remember, Prieto said, I'm 100% confident. I will win. I'm not here on vacation. Well, he needs a knockout.
Yes, he does.
And he hasn't fought a bad fight. You know, Alvarez made an adjustment around round six, round seven, and he's swept all the last rounds. Very smart corner with Mark Ramsey over there, and a very experienced fighter with a great amateur pedigree in Eladio Alvarez.
He brought everything he had, but Alvarez just a little bit too talented and experienced.
And Prieto wasn't able to make the adjustment after Alvarez did, and Alvarez is therefore taking over the fight.
And we're through round 12.
Prieto just looks gassed to me, Ray. Flat-footed, hands are down, just kind of lunging in every once in a while, so very important that he can land that overhand right if he wants to get back in this fight. But he's got to wait and time the jab of Alvarez to have any shot because he can't set it up right now.
It is 10 p.m. here in the East. We come to you from Bell Center in Montreal. Premier Boxing Champions, Kenny Albert, Sugar Ray Leonard, BJ Flores, and Kenny Rice. The 12th and final round. Light heavyweight bout between two unbeatens, both born in South America. Later, Alvarez from Colombia, now lives here in Montreal. Isidro Prieto, born in Paraguay, currently living in Argentina. Alvarez with the 7-point edge on Corey Irvin's scorecard over the first 11. Prieto needs a knockout. Down to 10 seconds. Neither fighter has lost as a professional. Alvarez and Prieto go the distance. Fans rising to their feet collectively here in Montreal, saluting both fighters. Isidro Prieto and a later Alvarez, who goes 12 rounds for the second time in his career. The decision when we return. Montreal, it is time for the decision. Alvarez and Prieto
go the distance to arena announcer Roland Mayotte.
La décision. The decision. Juge Lindemann, 117-111. Judge Lindemann, 117-111. Juge Rutchin, 117-111. Judge Rutchin, 117-111. Juge Whitburn, 117-111. Judge Whitburn, 117-111. Le gagnant, the winner, par décision unanime, by unanimous decision, est toujours invaincu, still undefeated, Helena Storm Alvarez!
So, Helena Alvarez remains unbeaten, now 18-0. The winner by unanimous decision over Isidro Prieto, who suffers the first loss of his professional career. Our final punch stats brought to you by Applebee's. Half-price apps every weekday, late afternoon and late night. Alvarez landed 40% of his total punches. Prieto, 24%. Alvarez landed 30% of his jabs. Prieto at 17%. Power punches, Alvarez 48%, Prieto 30. So Alvarez now 18-0. He is with our Kenny Rice.
Congratulations, another win here basically on what is home court. And I will go through Russ, your interpreter here. Russ, his thoughts on this fight.
¿Qué tú piensas de la pelea?
No, una pelea dura, bastante fuerte. De verdad que Isidro vino bien preparado, vino allá ese cinturón y bueno, dio una buena pelea.
It was a good fight, it was a hard fight. He came well prepared for the fight, it was a hard fight. He was a good fight, he's happy.
Were you frustrated at any time that he kept hanging in there and forced this to go the distance?
Un poquito frustración de esta parte porque la pelea se vamos a dos asaltos. Tu él mucho tough, mucho acro, holding. Es que tu piel es con frustración de tu parte.
Bueno, siempre me preparo para ganar y pues me preparo para si la pelea puede llegar a 12 asaltos. Pienso que no, si no hubiera estado preparado, la pelea no hubiera llegado a los 12 asaltos. Un poquito frustrado porque a veces no le salen las cosas como uno quiere, pero bueno, gracias a Dios se consiguió una victoria.
Thank God he got the win. He prepared to go the 12 rounds. He would have liked to end it sooner, but he prepared to go the 12, and he was ready to go the 12. He didn't want to, but he did, and he was ready for it.
He was indeed. Congratulations.
Felicidades.
No, thank you. Thank you very much.
Another win. He stays undefeated, Kenny.
And Alvarez said it will be the biggest challenge of his career, and he was up to the challenge, raising his record to 18-0 following his victory by unanimous decision over Isidro Prieto here at Bell Center in Montreal. Coming up, our main event as Lucien Boutte gets set to face Andrea De Luisa. When we return, it's Premier Boxing Champions from Montreal on NBCSN.